limit of a sum as definite integral. This is more important vis-a-vis the previous one. So in previous session, what did we learn? We learned that we can write an integral of a function from A to B as limit of h tending to 0 and n tending to infinity, h times summation of, okay, f of a plus r minus 1 h r from 1 to n. This is what we learned. Correct. Now, the same thing can be converted back to an integral if you are being asked a question like this. Now, remember here you are actually dealing with something which we call as tending to zero into infinity form. Tending to zero into infinity form. Okay. So I'll tell you the working rule. How do we convert a limit of a sum into a definite integral? Okay. And it is mostly applied where your indeterminate form is tending to zero into infinity form. Okay. So I'll tell you a working rule. Please note this down because it is going to help you to solve all the questions related to this. Suppose you have been given any limit to evaluate. So they would give you something like this. Let me take an example, very simple example I'll take. Let's say you have been asked to evaluate this limit. So with this particular concept, we are going to touch upon our limits chapter also, which was actually not completed fully. In the month of March, when I did that, it was not done fully with you. With this concept, it will be completed now. Okay, now let's say we have to evaluate this limit. How will you evaluate this? Let's say with your concept of limits, how will you evaluate this? By the way, most people will say, since n is infinity, this is tending to zero. This is also tending to zero. All these things are tending to zero. Okay, so answer will be zero. By the way, this is wrong if you are saying this. Why it is wrong? Because these quantities are not zero. They are actually tending to zero. If they were finitely many quantities like this, that means let's say there were 500 quantities like this, then you can say zero, no problem. But when such quantities are infinitely many in number, it will actually become, this is actually tending to zero into infinity, which is an indeterminate form. That means it can take any value. Okay. It need not be zero. It can take any value. Okay, so a small quantity present in infinitely many in number can give you a non-zero quantity as well. So this method will not work. Okay, any other approach to solve this question? Any approach that you know of can help you solve this question? I would love to hear it. Okay, I don't think so any one of you will be able to find it out. Okay, now the working rule is we normally write down number one, the rth term over here. Step number one is write down the rth term of the sum given to you. Okay, so in this example, okay, your rth term would be 1 by n plus r. Yes or no? As you can see, this term is always n. Okay. Only this term is varying from 1, 2, 3 till n. Okay. So your rth term will be n plus r. That is step number one. Step number two. Take 1 by n common from, okay, tr term. For example, in this case, if I take 1 by n out, it will become n by n plus r, right? 1 by n by n plus r, correct? Is step number 2 clear? So take 1 by n common from tr. If I take 1 by n common from tr, I'll be left with 1 by n times n by n plus r, correct? Okay. Let me call this term as gn. Okay. Okay, let me not name it. Or let me name it, because then I can refer to it. Okay. In fact, it is a function of both r and n. So I write it as function of r and n. Okay. Step number 3. This is the most important step. Convert g r n as a function of, let's say, r by n. For example, in this case, you can write n by n plus r as 1 by 1 plus r by n. Okay, so this is basically converted as a function of r by n. Okay, so two things. Number one, take 1 by n out. Number two, the remaining part of the function, convert it as a function of r by n. Okay. Fourth step. Do these following replacements. Number one replacement. Replace your 1 by n with a dx. Replace r by n with x. And summation with an integral sign. Okay. And the limits also. Limits accordingly. Now I'll explain this through this example. So what I'm going to do is, basically what I was trying to do, I was trying to sum up summation r, right? Okay. And the summation was going from n equal to r equal to 1 till n, where your n was very, very large number, right? This is what you were doing. So what you did now was you converted tr as 1 by n times 1 by 1 plus r by n, okay, r equal to 1 till n. Now what you have to do is replace this guy with a dx, replace this guy with an x, replace summation symbol with integration symbol. Now what about limit of integration? Now see, your x is r by n, right? You have put this as your x, right?
Yes, sir.
So when your r is 1, x will be
0.
Correct. So your lower limit will become 0. And when your r is n, your upper limit will become n by n, which is 1. So it will be integrated from 0 to 1. So this summation of, let me write, 1 by n plus r from 1 to n, where n is a very, very large number, will be converted to an integral like this. And once it is converted to an integral like this, you know how to evaluate it. So it is limit mod 1 plus x, 0 to 1. So that will give you ln 2. So this series that you see is actually ln 2, which is obvious also, because if you look at ln 1 plus x Maclaurin series expansion, it is given by x minus x square by 2, minus x cube by 3, and so on till infinity. Correct? If you put a 1, what do you get? 1 minus half, sorry, this is plus. Plus 1 third, minus 1 fourth, and so on till infinity. Correct? Does it match with this? Or is there any connection between these two? Hello? Somebody's trying to say something? It's very feeble. Who is this?
It is Siddhartha, sir.
Siddhartha. Yeah, Siddhartha. Hello? Siddhartha, can you hear me? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Why can't you put 1 in this series? Its radius of convergence is from minus 1 to 1, 1 inclusive. This is the radius of convergence. Got it? Okay, so I leave this as an exercise for you to figure out that this sum and this sum will converge to the same. Okay. Anyways, so you got an idea about what is the process involved when you are trying to convert the limit of a sum to a definite integral. Step number one, I'll repeat once again. Write your rth term. If you make a mistake in this, then no point going forward. Everything will become wrong from there on. Step number two, take 1 van out. Always, 1 van will always be taken out and that will play the role of your dx term. Step number three, whatever is the term remaining after taking 1 van out. Okay, this term. Write it as a function of r van. So here I will write it down. Your aim should be to write it as a function of r band, because ultimately we have to substitute r band as an x. Okay. And step number four, make these replacements. Change 1 band with dx, change r band with an x, change your summation symbol to integration symbol, and depending upon your r is going from what value to what value, your limit of integration will accordingly change. Is that clear? Let us take some examples on it. That will make it even more clearer. Let's take these four questions. Let me know the answer for the first one. First one, I think you do not need a definite integrals to evaluate it. I think sigma method of summation will work, but still I would like you to solve it by your limit of a sum as definite integral. Done first one?
One second. Sir, in somewhere in the middle, if 1 by n comes, that's directly 0, no?
No. Convert it to dx. 1 by n you just take out from the trth term. That 1 by n you reserve for a dx. Okay. And the rest of the function should definitely be a function of r by n somehow.
No, sir. I meant 1 by n is taken out and then you get r by n minus 1 by n. So that 1 by n minus 1.
No. You'll never get a case like that. Then some mistake is happening. See, r term here would be r by n square. Correct? No.
Yes, sir.
So when you take a 1 by n out, you'll be left with r by n. So this will be a straight away x.
Oh, okay. Yes, I got it.
So when you're doing a summation of this from r equal to 1 till n, in fact, n minus 1, okay, it doesn't make a lot of a difference to us. So what will happen? This will play the role of dx. This will play the role of x. Okay. So you're integrating x dx. Now, what is the limit of integration? Now remember, when r is 1, x will be 0. And when r is n minus 1, your x will be n minus 1 by n. And if you take a limit of this, it will actually be a 1. Correct. So it will be 0 to 1. That means it will be just x square by 2 from 0 to 1. That's nothing but a half. Okay. Anyhow, this was an easy problem which you could have done it in this way also. 1 plus 2 till n minus 1 by n square, limit n tending to infinity. So it will be a clear cut case of infinity by infinity. Okay. So this was nothing but n minus 1 into n by 2. Okay. And if you cancel this out and divide by n, you will get half limit n tending to infinity, 1 minus 1 by n. And 1 by n as n tends to infinity is 0, so it will be half again. Okay, so another method to do it. So we have just basically confirmed that our answer is correct, whether we go by this approach or whether we go by this approach. Second one we have already done, so you can skip the second one. You can go to the third one directly. Third one.
Sir, could you go down slightly?
Is that okay?
Yeah.
Done? 5 by 4? Okay, good.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Second.
Done. Okay. Again, quickly.
1 minute.
I'm directly writing it like this, okay? So that don't waste a lot of time. Correct. So now, just one shot it'll take to convert it to a function of r by n. So this is a function of r by n. I hope you understand the meaning of function of r by n. That means r by n should be the only composite term that is to be seen apart from constants. There should not be any stray r or stray n terms. Okay. So now if you're summing this up from r equal to 1 till n, it is like integrating 1 by 1 plus x square dx. Okay. Now remember your limit of integration will be from r is going from 1 to n, that means your limit of integration will be from 0 to 1. And that is nothing but tan inverse x from 0 to 1, which is pi by 4. Fourth one, please try out fourth one.
Sir, can you show the question? Thank you, sir.
I'll write it down. Limit n tending to infinity. 1 to the power p, 2 to the power p, till n to the power p. P is a positive power. Okay. Okay. So this is very easy again. Rth term would be what? Rth term would be r to the power p by n to the power p plus 1. If you take out a 1 by n out, it will be having a balanced power of r and p both in the numerator and denominator. Okay. So summing this up from r equal to 1 till n is like integrating x to the power p dx from 0 to 1. So it'll be x to the power p plus 1 by p plus 1, 0 to 1. So that will be 1 by p plus 1. Easy? Okay. So let's move on to the next set of questions. Okay. Do you have access to pages, Venkat?
I have another one on this. Okay. Kidding.
Very good. Pratham, Amla. Easy. So if you take n out, you will automatically see under root of 4 minus r by n the whole square. Okay. So clearly your summation of tr from r equal to 1 till n minus 1, sorry, 0 to n minus 1, okay, won't make a difference where your n is a very, very large quantity, will convert to 1 by integral of 4 minus x square dx. Now remember, when r is 0, x will be 0, and when r is n minus 1, x will tend to 1. Okay, so this will give you nothing but sine inverse of x by 2, 0 to 1, which is pi by 6. Can I go on to the next page?
Yes.
Evaluate limit n tending to infinity.
So can you go to the previous slide?
Just give me a second. Let me just write down this. N factorial by n to the power n whole raised to the power 1 by n. So please copy that, then I'll go to the previous slide. Done? Copied? Okay. Somebody wanted to look, have a look at the previous slide. Okay, here you go.
Thank you.
Any idea? See, first of all, you have to take a log. That is for sure. Okay. Take a log to the base E on both the sides. Remember, log can be applied to this function directly. So it'll be 1 by n ln of n factorial. Now, n factorial, you write it as 1, 2, 3 till n. And this n to the power n, you distribute between these terms like this. That's a hint for you. Now you can proceed from here on. So think as if this is a new limit problem that you have been given. How will you evaluate it? Okay, let me give you a further hint on this. So this will be 1 by n ln 1 by n. Okay, 1 by n ln 2 by n. And so on till 1 by n ln n by n. Correct. So if you pick out any rth term from this, your rth term here will be 1 by n ln r by n. Okay, so automatically 1 by n is being separated out. So your summation of tr from r equal to 1 till n will be nothing but integral of ln x dx from 0 to 1, if I'm not wrong. This is something which we already know, x ln x minus x from 0 to 1. Correct? And that's going to give you, when you put a 1 here, everything will become a 0 other than a minus 1 here. And when you put a 0, everything will become a 0. So finally, log of the limit to the base e is equal to minus 1. That means the limit value is 1 by e. Correct? Correct, Tripan? Is the idea clear? So don't shy away from taking a log. Okay. After taking a log, that gets converted to a series. Write down the rth term of a series. Take out the 1 by n term, treat it as dx. The remaining term, write it as a function of r by n. Replace your r by n with an x and integrate it. Replace your summation symbol with an integration symbol. And depending upon from where to where you are integrating, okay, your limits of integration will change. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, try this one out. This one would be a relatively easier one for you to crack now. Done. Very good. What is the answer, Venkat?
It's a log 3.
Okay. There are two types of answers I'm getting. One is log 3 and log 3 by 2. Okay, never mind. Let's check. Okay. Now, if you take a 1 by n common from here, you will end up getting, correct me if I'm wrong, 2 plus r by n.
R by n, yes.
So your summation is happening from r equal to 1 till 4n, my dear.
Yes, sir.
Limit n tending to infinity. Okay. That means your integration will be 1 by x plus 2 dx from 0 to 4. So this will give you ln mod x plus 2. From 0 to 4, that is ln 6 minus ln 2, which is ln 3. Is that fine? So this problem I gave you because I wanted you to be careful about from where to where you are summing it up. You're not summing it to 3n. That means your r is not going from 1 to n. It is going from 1 to 4n. Okay, so your limit of integration will become 0 to 4. So be careful about that. Next question. Let me put the poll on for this. See. 2 minutes gone.
One minute.
Okay. All right, last 15 seconds. Just 4 of you have responded so far. I would like all of you to put your response on the poll. Okay, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, almost 4.5 minutes gone in this question. So most of you have gone with option A. The second highest vote has gone to option C. Okay. Of course, the first thing that would come to your mind is, if let's say I call this as your L, you take log to the base E on both the sides, isn't it? So this would convert to limit n tending to infinity. This will become 1 by n log of sine pi by 2n plus log of sine 2 pi by 2n. Okay. I'm interested in what is going to be my last term that it shows like this. So basically, it is nothing but log of sine of, correct me if I'm wrong, it's 2 times n minus 1 pi by 2n, isn't it? That's the only way I can get a n minus 1 pi by n over here. Right? Now, basically, it tells us that your rth term was actually 1 by n ln of sine r pi by 2n. Okay. And you are trying to sum up the series from r equal to 1 till 2 times n minus 1. Am I right? Isn't it? See, look here carefully. Your r is varying from 1 to till 2 times n minus 1.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this will get converted to, let me just make the convergence. N tending to infinity. Let's write everything that makes this look correct. Yeah, so this will become ln sine. This will become a x term. So this will become sine pi x by 2. Okay, limit of integration will become from 0 to 2, my dear. Please note that. Please note that it will be from 0 to 2. Correct? Now let us write pi x by 2 as a t. So dx will be 2 by pi dt. So this will be 2 by pi ln sine t dt. And your limits of integration, if I'm not wrong, will become from 0 to pi. Correct? This is your ln L, ln L. Okay. Now this term seems to satisfy this property that f of t is f of pi minus t, isn't it? That means I can use half the limit property. So it'll be 2 times 0 to pi by 2 ln of sine t dt. Now this integral must be known to you by now.
Pi by 2 log half.
Pi by 2 log half. Absolutely. So it'll be 2 ln half that will come out from here, because pi by 2 and 2 by pi will get cancelled. 2 will be left off. Okay, so this guy will get cancelled with this. And this will be ln L, which clearly means L is 1/4. L is 1/4. So which option? Option number C. Janta was wrong. Okay.
Sir, 1 minute, sir. Just could you show the last part?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. All right, let's take up one last problem on this, and then we can probably, take a break and start with differential equations. So let's have one more problem. Evaluate limit n tending to infinity summation of root r from r equal to 1 till n summation of 1 by root r from r equal to 1 to n by summation of r from 1 to n. So this has been multiplied. Yes, any breakthroughs?
1 second, sir. Sir, can a bunch of terms be considered as a kth term or something?
There should be a series, no? A series should come out. But these are there are three series operating here. This is a series, this is a series, this is a series.
Okay, sir, okay.
So in the present form, whatever you're trying to apply, that might not fit in.
Okay, sir.
Okay, let's have a look at this. What I'll do here is, this term I will write it as summation under root of r by n. That means n I have introduced. Remember, summation is applied to r, not on n. So n is like a constant. You can introduce it to any term. Okay, at the same time, I'll put under root n over here. Okay. Similarly, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make this as under root of n by r. Correct? So since I've multiplied with root n, I have to divide with the root n. So this root n is basically non-existent for me. Then this term will go off. Okay. Now, this term I'm going to do here 1 by n and r by n. That means I have introduced 1 by n square in the denominator, right? So I'll give 1 by n to this and I'll give 1 by n to this in the numerator. Okay. And limit is basically following this algebra. So we can apply limit on this separately. Correct. So I can see this as a three definite integral problems. So here I can see this as a dx. Correct. This has under root of x, so you're integrating under root of x dx from 0 to 1 into this. I'm seeing as under root of 1 by x, or you can say 1 by root x 0 to 1. And this, of course, is integration of x dx from 0 to 1. Okay, so this will be your desired limit. So let us evaluate this. So this comes out to be, if I'm not mistaken, 2 by 3. Okay. This is 2 root x, so that will give you a 2. And this will give you a half. So your answer is 8 upon 3. Correct, Aniruddha. Is this fine? Any questions, any concerns? Okay. Now we'll take a break. Since it is a 3.5 hours class, I'll give you a 10 minutes break. Okay. So right now, as per my watch, it is 6:46. Let's meet at 6:56. Okay. On the other side of the break, we'll start with